I have in studio with me, it's Manhood Hour, and I'm going to get to your call soon here in a minute. I apologize, but I have with me a young man that we invited my producer there here, and I'm glad they did. He is late. He is black. And he is real late. And normally we don't take guests when they're late, but my producer, Nick, said, Jesse, let's do it, please. He's a nice guy. Amazing Lucas is here. And Amazing Lucas is an artist and a YouTuber. He's also an athlete. Is that right?
That's correct.
Oh, good. Welcome, man.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Amazing Lucas. It's amazing that you're late.
Yeah, I mean, it's L.A. traffic with the rain, with a little bit of, it's a perfect storm, we'll say that.
That's for sure. Black people already have excuses.
It's CPT, color people time. You already knew I was going to be late.
Blame it on the rain.
I knew deep down inside, you're like, he's going to be late.
I did. I said, when I found out you were black, I'm like, he'll be late. I mean, you sure, Nick?
I wanted to make sure. I was like, you know what? I'm not going to be late. I'm not going to be late.
Amazing.
I think it's in the DNA.
And that's for sure. It's in the D and something. Oh, God. So why do they call you Amazing Lucas?
Amazing Lucas.
What does that mean?
It basically started from videos. People were like, oh, this is an amazing video. Oh, this is great. You know, and then eventually just calling, just like, oh, that was Amazing Lucas. I was like, oh, I like the sound of that.
Oh, I see. And so how did you get started and why did you just on YouTube?
I just figured I could do it. Yeah. I started off in fitness, and then from fitness, you know, progressed to where I am now.
And so speaking of fitness, you are a bodybuilder,
I used to compete, yeah.
You used to compete?
I used to compete.
Really?
I'm a little small right now.
You don't compete anymore?
Not anymore.
Why did you stop?
There's no money in competing.
Oh, it's not?
It's not.
Oh. And I'm working with a guy now who is attend my church and stuff, and he's like, Jesse, I can get you in shape. And he was he competed. I think he has one coming up next year. He's getting ready for
it
now.
What competition though? Are we doing physique, classic physique, bodybuilding?
Yeah.
Which one?
I don't know. Okay. I just know he compete, and he has an amazing body.
All right.
He's really, really good shape. Okay. And he's really getting me in good shape too. He really knows how to cause you to lose weight and sculpture the body. And I like that.
As long as you're building muscle, right?
Yeah.
No steroids.
No steroids. Right? Okay, okay. No. I've heard too many horror stories about those things. Did you take any of those?
No steroids. All natural.
Really? So how were you able to get your body without the steroid to go to that?
Just hard work and eating. So I'm naturally an ectomorph, so that means I'm just naturally skinny. So usually with like people who are just naturally skinny, you have to eat a lot and train heavy.
Yeah. Yeah, he's teaching me to eat. Right.
Right. There we go.
Steaks.
No more fried chicken.
Chicken, right. No more fried chicken. I still love my chicken. And so, are you a Christian?
I am.
Oh, let me ask you, why did you stop competing?
Because
money.
Yeah, it's nothing.
So, did you make money while competing?
No.
When you were competing?
How that works out is that you either get with a supplement company, but thanks to, you know, social media, all that changed. Where now you don't even really have to compete. You just have to have a good body and sell merch and stuff or supplements or whatever you're.
Where are you from?
I'm from L.A., born and raised.
Oh, you were born and raised in L.A.?
Thug life on the chest. What? Yes.
Really?
Of course.
That's odd. I don't see a lot of people. I don't run into a lot of people.
I know. A lot of foreigners here. Yeah. A lot of transplants. We got to kick them out.
So are you a Christian?
Yeah.
You're a Christian. And what does it mean to be a Christian?
A disciple of Christ, follower of Christ.
And so do you sin?
Do I sin?
No, do you sin?
Currently?
Do you sin?
Do I sin?
No, do you sin?
Do I sin? That's the question, right?
No, do you sin?
Do I sin? I'm just repeating the question to make sure I have it right. Do I sin?
You got it right.
Okay.
Oh, you got the question right.
Do I sin? Yes.
And what type of sins? So as a Christian, you still sin.
Yeah, I do.
What type of sins do you commit?
Not perfect. Let's see. I'm trying to think. I probably have lied.
You probably have?
Probably. I don't remember my last lie.
So you haven't lied lately?
I haven't lied lately.
Have you lied since being a Christian?
Have I lied since being a Christian? I have.
You have?
I have.
And so do you believe that as a son of God, you could be perfect?
Do I believe as a son of God, you can be perfect? I believe that's the purpose of Christ dying on the cross, is that you are imperfect. Because if you were perfect, there'd be no reason for him to die on the cross for your sins.
And since he died on the cross and you become his brother.
Born new.
Can you be perfect?
Can you be perfect? I don't believe so.
You don't think you can become perfect?
I don't think so.
How about become perfect?
Become perfect. I guess become perfect in Christ.
What is the purpose of becoming a Christian if you're still going to be sinning? Why be saved by God from sin, right?
Mm-hmm.
If you're still sinning, how do you know you're saved?
Well, it's the fact that you believe that Christ died on the cross for your sins and you repent. Now, you may backslide, but the point of the backsliding is the fact that you admit that you are sinning, as opposed to someone who may be sinning who doesn't feel, they don't care that they're sinning.
So does the Bible say you can backslide and admit you're sinning and hallelujah, go ahead?
And you can repent, yeah.
Amazing. So I got to ask you, what is your podcast primary? What do you deal with?
What do I deal with? I deal with a variety of things. Everything from politics to fitness to entertainment, video games.
And how old are you?
I'm an old man.
You're a millennial?
Yeah.
Oh, you are a millennial.
Uh-huh.
So you got to be in your late 30s. When you say old man, you don't look late 30s, but
well,
you say that.
I'll take whatever you give. Whatever you throw, I'll take it.
How old are you?
I don't disclose my age.
Oh, you don't? Amazing.
Amazing.
That's amazing.
I still do animation, so I like to keep everything under the wraps.
Uh-huh.
Because, in Hollywood, they're like, what's this? I know this guy. So that's the only reason why.
Okay. That makes sense. So you were banned on Twitter, I read.
That is correct. Wow, you got your, did your due diligence.
I'm black. I'm slow, but I ain't that black and slow.
Yeah.
Why were you banned on Twitter?
I said something about trans women aren't real women, something like that. Something.
You were banned because you said they're not real women?
Yeah.
Why would they ban you for that?
Well, because I believe that goes against their hate speech policy.
Oh, they thought that was hate speech?
Yeah.
To speak the truth?
I know.
Amazing. So, are you back on now? Aren't you?
Yeah, I am.
So, how long did they ban you for?
No, it's not the same account. That account is gone.
Oh, it is?
I had to get a new one. This is like my third or fourth account. But I'm not really on. I just have it to have it.
Oh, I see.
Because you waste too much time.
Yeah.
You get into like these little Twitter battles, and then they'll just block you. And it's like, I just wasted 30 minutes trying to explain to you why you're incorrect. It's a waste of time.
Why do you think Twitter is so willing to ban people of different opinion? We have a right in America to agree and disagree. That's what America is about. And if you hate, you have a right to hate if you want. You suffer for hating in life. But how come they are doing those things, you think?
I think you can hate. You just can't hate on their platform. And the great thing about hate is who defines what
right.
hate is. That's where the loophole is.
But the people who are disagreeing with you, are they hating too? Because they just
not
agree
from their
with you.
Perspective. It's just, what do you really expect? These are people who can't tell distinguish the difference between a man and a woman. You expect them to know what hate is? Come on now.
That's amazing. So I wanted, because of you being late, now I have to rush through my stuff.
It's okay.
Amazing. Black people screw you up every time.
It's sweet.
But you seem like a nice guy.
Short and sweet.
So I want to ask, you know who Nick
Fuentes.
Fuentes, right?
Fuentes, yeah.
Nice young man, I think. What's your impression of Nick?
I think Nick is a very interesting individual.
In what way?
In the way of his beliefs, of why he believes what he believes, and then how he goes about expressing those beliefs.
And what are his beliefs, in your opinion?
In my opinion? Well, I did an interview with him. I don't want to misquote him, but he believes that, we should crack down on immigration. We need, I believe, more white people import more, whether, they're in the country or not.
Speaking to the mic for me.
Oh, there we go.
Yeah.
Is that better? Okay.
Uh-huh. So he believes in more white people in America and get rid of
America's it's white country.
Right. And what do you say about you agree with that?
I feel he's entitled to his opinion.
But do you agree with it?
Do I agree that America is a white, that it's a white country?
Yes.
I'm not sure if I do.
Why not?
Because I don't know what he means by that.
I had him on my show too, but mm-hmm. I'm not speaking for him. I believe that white people, well, I know that white people founded and created the greatest country in the world, right? Mm-hmm. And now the people of color are taking over and they're screwing everything up mm-hmm. and then they're blaming white people for their weakness. And so the whites are afraid and they stop having babies and they're just kind of shutting down.
Yeah, I think that was one of his arguments where he wants to maintain a white majority.
Yeah, I believe that white people better start having some more white babies.
They can't have white babies if they think trans women are women.
I know.
two negatives don't equal, you know, a baby.
But if we get, if white people become the minorities in this country, it's over for America. It'll become
a
ghetto.
But who's allowing that to happen?
The whites are.
Okay.
So do you agree with Nick that we need more white babies and white people need to try to keep America white?
Knock yourself out.
Do you agree, though, that if it become a ghetto, if white people become...
If it becomes a ghetto, I mean, here's how I see it, it's game over either way.
What do you mean?
I mean, I just see, because what has been happening under Trump, what they've gotten past when it comes to trans, when it comes to the policies in schools and stuff like that, under a Republican administration, I mean, once they get in office, it's game over. It's not going to happen. And then when it comes to immigration, wall is great, but unless you change the rules within the country, it's like saying, yeah, if you can get past this wall— you know, you're home free. Then, of course, I'm going to try my hardest to get past the wall, regardless of how big or how long or how intimidating
that
wall
is. Are you for the wall?
Yeah.
Oh, the wall going up.
Wall's going up. We just need some new wall.
And so do you
agree? We need Israel's wall. That's what we need.
Yeah. We really do. Do you agree, though, that white people need to start having more white babies? We need to keep the country white as
not
much
all of
as
them,
possible.
Jesse, not all. Not all. The whites that believe, you know, that, you know, a ma'am is a woman, they don't need to have babies. They need to stop having babies.
But how about for normal white people? Don't they need to continue to run their own country? Otherwise, it's going to end up as an asshole
country. They don't believe that, though.
But do you believe it?
Do I believe that they need it?
Yeah.
I believe what they believe.
Which is
that, yo, they want to give it to you, Jesse. They want you to run the country.
But do you believe that white people should maintain control?
Do I believe that white people should maintain control? I mean, they have control right now.
Do you agree with me that they should maintain control?
Based off where the country is right now, I don't know if I can go that far.
So you don't agree that they should maintain control?
I think
control?
We need to switch. If the white people aren't running the country right now, well, we need to switch them out for a different group of white people then.
But the whites who are running it now are really not running it. Some are there, but they're being controlled by the people of color.
So white people are being controlled by black people?
Blacks and foreigners and everybody else
they
that come here.
They can't be controlled by black people.
But just because of time, do you believe that white people should maintain control?
I feel like they should do whatever best in their interest.
And should they maintain control of the country?
I don't know. Based off of where it is, I don't think that's a very strong argument.
And do you agree that if they lose control, that we're gonna end up in South Africa? What's happening in South Africa? What happened in America?
It's gonna be Jesse. I already got my what is it called? My passport. I'm ready. I'm ready to go back to Africa. I'm ready. Because it's going to be game over here.
But the same thing is happening in Africa. The blacks have taken over. It's all hell.
Yeah, I mean, I'm sure there's probably certain sects in Africa where I'd be safe.
You think so?
I think so.
I got to ask you, I have a YouTube question for you from Glock Shots. Ask, does Lucas support the push to free Rodney Reed, whoever that is?
Rodney Reed.
You know who that is?
Yeah, I know Rodney
Reed.
Who is
Rodney Reed?
I've gotten a lot of flack for that for some reason. So many people are conflating his past alleged crimes with the one that's held in court right now, which is.
Who is Rodney Reed?
Rodney Reed, oh my God, a long story. Essentially, he was accused of raping a woman.
A black guy?
Yeah, black guy.
He black.
He black. Yeah. And the evidence that has come out is that the DNA, which was the main source of evidence to find him guilty,
yeah.
is now proven that it wasn't from rape. It was from consensual sex.
And so you want him free?
I think the evidence, not necessarily free, but as far as a retrial.
Oh, but not free.
Yeah. Why be free? I say we have a retrial based off the evidence that's been now presented to us, new evidence, and then take it from there.
You have another question. Do you have an opinion on social media platforms being regulated by the government?
I think that may be a slippery slope because, like I said, there's going to be eventually a Democratic president. So if they're the one that's controlling the social media, I mean, we can see with Obamacare. Once he got in, he put in a law that we're still being impacted from.
Yes.
So that I think that's one of the benefits of Democrats. They don't play games.
What's your opinion of Turning Point USA?
Turning Point is a very interesting organization. I think when it comes to conservatism or Republicanism or whatever is going on right now, I don't know what's happening, okay? Because I know back in the day, conservatives, we weren't for gay marriage.
Right.
We weren't for the alphabet community, which I did coin that phrase. Dave Chappelle owes me money. But weren't for any of that.
You?
He did take it from me.
Are you a conservative?
I don't know anymore. Because if that's what they're promoting, I can't be a part of that.
Right.
That's not as far as Christianity.
Yeah.
And that's what kills me when you have people who are like, oh, this is a gay Christian. I'm like, what?
I know. How are you going to be a gay Christian?
How does that work, pimpin'? Yeah. And then you have people within that community around these people who aren't saying anything.
Right.
So that's where I see the term of conservative ink in these individuals who just come out of the woodworks who are pretty much salesmen. They're salespeople, right? They don't necessarily have to believe what they're selling. They just have to be good at selling it.
Why do you think Turning Point is pushing homosexuality upon the Republican Party, conservative party?
Because there's no pushback. I see what's happening here, instead of being selective with who you let in, like in L.A., right? There's certain places where you can't come to this restaurant looking like that, right? Well, instead of that practice and strategy, what they're doing is just opening the gate. So everyone come in. You know, we need the votes in order to win the election. But what they don't understand is they're going for the short term and completely, you know, forgetting about the long term.
So is Nick Fuente, is he correct in fighting against that, he and the people who are doing it?
In that aspect,
yeah,
absolutely.
They're right in
absolutely,
fighting
100%.
Against that. There is a black guy that represents, I guess he's one of the speakers with Turning Point.
Rob Smith?
Yeah, Rob Smith. I saw him on, did you know he had a husband?
I did.
I saw him on Tucker Carlson saying that he had a husband. I spilled my coffee everywhere. Yeah. I was like, ain't no black man got
have you
no
seen,
husband.
Have you seen the amazing advertisement he did for the dating app?
I want to play it for you right now.
Oh, please do.
I want you folks to see this with Rob Smith and his husband.
Hey, you. Are you still single?
If so, you need to download Tame Me, the new dating app for the entire LGBTQIA+ community.
Because winter is coming, and you want to have a cuddle buddy.
Jesse, did you download it?
Yeah, I don't know. Nick, my producer got it. No, he didn't get the ad, but I mean...
Okay, we're backtracking now?
Yeah, he didn't get the dating app. He got that commercial.
Okay. I thought he got the dating
promo.
App. Okay.
No way. But let me ask, are you surprised a black man talking about he got a husband and that he's that gay?
Of course not. They've been going for the black community for a while. The white community is done. They've already injected the alphabet community and the propaganda in them. But the black community, we still like, we don't play that.
Yeah.
So what happened is you've seen a lot of people coming out, you know, this black person, this black celebrity, this person. Oh, yeah.
But why is it that Rob Smith is not embarrassed or I don't care about him being gay, mm-hmm. as long as he keep it private or to himself, right?
Mm-hmm.
Why do you think he's not embarrassed to be on TV being black? Because black people don't normally say that kind of stuff. You know, they kind of keep it to themselves if they are because they know it's wrong.
Uh-huh.
Why do you think he's so bold out there with it like that?
I think it has to do with the conditioning of America for it, right? Because there's been polls of how, you know, Americans feel about gay marriage currently. And many are okay with it, as opposed to, you know, 5 years or 6 years ago. And that's because it's been it is ubiquitous right now. You see it in the television, you see it in games, you see it in movies, you see it in everywhere, right? So it's a conditioning process, just like the trans. And where that route is heading and where they're going to take that.
That's amazing. Let's take we got to rush through a call because you're late.
I know.
I'm not going to let you
live
it down.
Maybe you will invite me back on again.
You think?
I'll sleep in the back. That way I'll be on time.
And you still find a reason to be late. Let's go to Tony out of West Palm Beach, Florida. Tony, welcome to the show. You're on with amazing Lucas.
Jesse, thank you so much for taking my call.
Yes, sir.
I got a question for the amazing Lucas. He made a claim that there was new evidence to suggest a consensual relationship between Rodney Reed and Stacey Stites. There is no new evidence. The supposed evidence is that somebody in jail overheard Jimmy Fennell, her ex-husband, confess. But he denies that. So the supposed new evidence is a testimony from a convicted white supremacist felon. That's not evidence. That's just somebody's claim. Number two, their other supposed evidence is family members saying that, oh, I saw Rodney with her. I saw Rodney here. But during the trial, the defense team's witness that said they claimed they saw Stacy, number one, admitted that she had no evidence of a consensual relationship. And number two, said Stacy's name wrong on the stand. She said Stephanie. So there's literally no proof of a consensual relationship, and the amazing Lucas is going around making that claim, which is outlandish.
You say? Because of time.
Well, he's incorrect on both regards. When it comes to the evidence for
him. Speak into the mic for me.
When it comes to the evidence, well, we have the medical examiners who said the DNA evidence is now, they recant what they previously said, which was signs of rape. Yeah. They're now saying that it's signs of consensual sex. In addition to that, you also had a deputy sheriff who I believe it was, I forgot, but he also says that there was a relationship between. That is true. You can look it up. I did a video on it.
You're wrong.
Check it out.
The original medical examiner said there was dilation in the anus. The other men, when they came back, they said there was no dilation in the anus, and it could have been. Just from her body.
Well, if you look at the documentary,
in her vagina from Rodney Reed, there was saliva on her chest.
We're from the
well, if there's a sexual encounter, of course there's going to be saliva.
So Stacey Stites went home to her husband with Rodney Reed's saliva on her chest, went to bed with him, and then woke up with him the next day and went off to work. That's
well, if you
saying?
Look at the if you look at the as far as the documentary. It covers all of that when it talks about the anus.
Like the Central Park 5 documentary? How about you read the actual evidence instead of propaganda films?
Well, I'm sorry that you feel that. It's a propaganda film. I just choose to be, you know, to take information from the left, from the right, in the middle.
The Central Park 5 documentary, that was a real thing, too.
I'm
right?
not sure what
that
the Central Park 5
film?
Has to do with Rodney Reed, but you're entitled to your opinion, my guy.
Well, your position is that Stacey Stites had sex with Rodney Reed consensually, and then she went home
That's
to her ex-husband.
What the medical examiner said. They said that the semen, not the semen, yeah, I believe it was the semen, was 72 hours old. Was 72 hours old.
There was saliva on her chest.
Tony.
If there is sexual encounter, yes, there's going to be saliva on
Tony,
the chest.
Thank
probably
you, man.
Saliva so all over the body if you're doing it right,
yeah.
Pimpin.
Keep spreading those lies, buddy.
Thank you, Tony.
Propaganda movies.
There's nothing.
Yeah, racist and murderous free. Great job.
Okay,
real
bro.
Amazing, Lucas. You should
okay.
be proud of yourself.
I am. Thank you. Thank you for the call, my guy.
You know what, folks? I'm so out of time.
Holy
I'm
moly.
Sorry about this, but Lucas was late, so it's his fault that the conversation was short, all right? It's not my fault. He black.
Look up what I said, people. Look up what I said. It's that simple.
Listen to your podcast and all that.
It's The Amazing Lucas on YouTube, The Amazing Lucas on Instagram, and Ask Amazing Lucas on Twitter.
Are you married?
I'm not.
Oh, okay.
I'm looking for wifey.
He's looking for a wife.
Yo, all the ladies, hit me up in the DMs.
Take my advice. Don't look for a wife. Add it on to you. Otherwise, you're going to get the wrong woman.
That's true.
You want to pick Satan's daughter?
I'm trying to have a little Lucas, so I have more black babies. If they can have more white babies, we need more black babies to balance that out.
Well, as long as they have noble parents.
Of course.
Thank you all for tuning in. The Hate Report is coming up next. The Hate Report. Thank you, man.
Thank you.
All right. amazing. And don't forget to like, follow, tweet, subscribe, and share the Jesse Lee Peterson Radio Show, folks. We really appreciate it. We are at war. It is a spiritual battle for the soul of America. And it's going to take all of us to do it.